Hemiplegic migraine is a rare type of migraine affecting around 800,000 people worldwide. The average age of onset is between 12 to 17 years old, and women are 3 times more likely to be diagnosed with this condition. Hemi means half, and plegic means paralysis. The distinguishing symptom of hemiplegic migraine is one-sided weakness or paralysis. Attacks may be accompanied by a headache, or one can follow shortly after. The weakness is a form of aura and is accompanied by at least one other aura symptom, such as visual changes. The weakness is not always on the same side as the head pain and can vary from mild to severe. Most individuals who experience hemiplegic migraine also experience more typical migraine attacks. Hemiplegic migraine may affect only part of the body, such as the face or a hand or arm. Weakness of the entire side of the body can also occur. Symptoms can also include loss of balance and coordination, difficulty speaking, fever, dizziness, impaired consciousness, and brain fog. There are 2 types of hemiplegic migraine. One is sporadic hemiplegic migraine, which happens in a person without a family history of hemiplegic migraine, although gene mutations may still be involved. The second is known as familial hemiplegic migraine, where one or more first-degree relatives also have this condition. So far, scientists have found abnormal defects in 4 genes related to familial hemiplegic migraine: CACNA-A1A, ATP1A2, SCN1A, PRRT2. At least 25% of families don't have any of these 4 mutations, leading scientists to believe more genes could be involved. Hemiplegic migraine can also be the result of brain trauma. Treatment is similar to classic migraine with aura, with the exception of triptans and ergot alkaloids. These medications can cause constriction of blood vessels and increase the risk of stroke. NSAIDs, verapamil, and anti-nausea medications are abortive choices, as well as intranasal ketamine for familial hemiplegic migraine. Verapamil can also be used as a preventative therapy. Other preventative options include ketamine, acetazolamide, naloxone, flunarizine, and for non-responders, lamotrigine may be effective. For prevention, beta blockers remain controversial. A hemiplegic migraine attack can closely resemble a transient ischemic attack or stroke. If you believe you are having a hemiplegic migraine attack, go to the emergency room and do not self-diagnose. A CT scan or MRI can rule out stroke. Remember, those with hemiplegic migraine can also have a stroke, and it may be difficult to distinguish. Examination by a headache specialist is necessary. Learn more at migrainedisorders.org.